Today, we're going to go over a few of the possible setup configurations of the Spyglass reactor. First, let's set it up using a Ceche pump. There's a volute cover on the pump, and we want to remove that. Now you can screw on the pump adapter to the output side of the pump. Now we can install the suction cups. For the nano pump, you will remove the entire volute. You're going to swap it out for the second version that comes inside the pump box. The pump adapter is a press fit for this pump. Now we can install the suction cups like this. Place the pump in the output chamber so the output adapter is close to the center and the intake is facing the hole in the side. Place the reactor on the pump. Make any adjustments needed for proper alignment. And this is the passive recirculating mode C, which works great for biopellets. To change to mode A for use with carbon, GFO, or medias where you want a little more turnover, simply remove the pump and thread on the input bar that comes with the pump. The volute cover that we removed prior has a pop-out valve adjustment that we want to remove. Then install the cover over the barb to keep the assembly tight. Now we can place the pump back in the outer chamber. Slide the half-inch tubing over the barb. And add the control valve to the input side. This will be used to regulate the flow for various medias. For fully recirculating mode B, we are simply going to remove the input barb and valve. Replace your reaction chamber. And use the clear Schedule 40 tubing inserted into the outer chamber saddle. You can also use rigid half-inch Schedule 40 for this. And both are a nice tight fit. Mode B is great if you want to fine-tune your effluent flow rates for biopellet use. Finally, let's set up the single pass using a manifold feed, mode D. place the manifold assembly T in the base of the reactor. Then push the clear Schedule 40 tubing through the outer chamber and into the side of the T. Then, we're going to install the valve on the input side using the heavy-duty clamp. This is going to take a pair of pliers to tighten down fully. That's it. And now it's set up to run off any pump or manifold feed you want to attach to it, and the flows can easily be regulated. Let's go over a few of the screen options. Here I have the large mesh plastic screen. It is the one you want to use for biopellets and large grain medias. Most often this screen is used with the rubber ball in the bottom. Alternately, if you are using less than half the media capacity, or you want a slower feed rate to gently tumble the media, you can use one of the bottom screens in lieu of the ball. Here is a small stainless screen that simply presses into the bottom. This would combine with a stainless top screen and can be used for very lightly tumbling small amounts of GFO or similar medias. For slower tumbling or lesser amounts of biopellets, we can also use the plastic mesh bottom screen. This inserts into the bottom, and then a rubber retainer ring is placed behind it. Now let's move to the foam. The large donut foam goes around the reaction chamber. The main purpose of this pad is to slow the water flow and make the whole unit quieter. The last configuration for the media plate we want to look at is the mesh combined with a foam pad for super fine medias like Purigen. We want to stack the stainless screen with the foam insert inside the top plate assembly. We will orient this so that the foam is below the mesh in the reactor. This setup should be used with the stainless bottom mesh and no ball. These are most, but not all, of the ways you can set up your Spyglass reactor. Feel free to mix and match and experiment with different modes and medias to determine what works best for your tank. If you find a preferred method that works for you and we haven't listed here, please share in the comments below. We'd love to hear from you.